Let's build a common emitter amplifier circuit because that's one of my favorites. Let's start with F2, and we're going to want an NPN transistor. NPN. Okay. Let's zoom out a little bit. Right click. We want to actually pick a realistic transistor, not just an ideal model. Pick a new transistor. These are very, very common transistors. 2N2222. I've got a couple of those in my parts box, so that sounds great. Okay, we'll add a resistor on the collector, a resistor on the emitter, a couple of resistors to form the DC voltage bias. Let's add a capacitor so that we're only amplifying AC. Let's add another capacitor so that there's an AC path to ground. And let's add a resistor there so we can have some control over the gain. Let's start drawing some wires now. Okay, almost done. Never ever forget ground. Now we're going to want two separate voltage sources here. F2, go to voltage source. Let's put a voltage source here. That voltage source should be referenced to ground. Do that. Voltage source over there. And at the top of our voltage divider. Now, this is where DC voltage sources come into play. Let's give it a DC voltage of 9 volts. We're going to power our amplifier with that. And like I said, we need a second voltage source. We need an input signal that we're going to amplify. Voltage source here, escape, reference it to ground, of course. F3 to draw the little wires. Excellent. Okay, let's add some component values. I have built so many of these things that I know by heart that this little trick will work. Make all the resistors 10K. Except for this one. Let's make the one that controls the gain a very low value of 1. We want a lot of gain. And we make the capacitor values pretty high, 1 microfarad, so that we let as much AC through as possible so we get a large AC gain. And don't worry if you don't know values off by heart like I do. This is just to show you how to construct the circuit in the simulator and simulate it, then tweak it, and just see what happens. Now, this time, we don't want to do an AC analysis sweep of a whole lot of frequencies. We just want to see how this amplifier performs at one specific frequency. Let's say 400 Hz, because that's roughly a male voice. Right click, advanced. We're not going to put in the small signal value over here. We're going to use the function, sine, DC offset, 0 volts, amplitude, very small, let's make it 20 millivolts, frequency, 400 hertz, and we can just leave the rest blank. Okay, time to set up the simulation, edit simulation command. We're not doing AC analysis anymore. What we want to do now is called a transient analysis. Now, what the transient analysis does is it starts up the circuit at certain default values. For example, 9 volts over here and 0 volts for the initial sine wave over here. And then it calculates every single voltage in the entire circuit, every voltage, every current at every node at a fraction of a second later. And then it'll do it again a fraction of a second later. It'll just keep doing that over and over and over again until you get graphs of voltage versus time, current versus time, for every single voltage in the circuit. And the only value we really need to change here is the stop time. This determines how long we're going to run the simulation for. So let's run it for 100 milliseconds, which is actually quite a long time. Okay, put the box wherever I want. Now, simulate, run. And this is the output of our amplifier. Let's see what happens. So check it out. On the output, we have a voltage swing of about a volt peak to peak. On the input, what do we have? That tiny little 20 millivolt input signal. So the amplifier is working great. We have a DC offset. I mean, we can easily remove that with a capacitor over here, but the amplifier is working exactly as expected. Now let's have some fun tweaking the circuit. Let's say I don't want a volt peak to peak. Let's say I think that's just too much. I only want to have half a volt peak to peak. Let's reduce the gain of this amplifier. So I go over here. Changing this resistor value will do that. Let's change that to 100 ohms. Okay. Simulate again. Output. Well, it looks like we've got 5.6 volts minus 4.6 volts. We still have 1 volt peak to peak, so that didn't reduce the gain of the amplifier like I wanted it to. So we're going to have to go over here again and tweak the value. Let's change it to 1 kiloohm. Simulate it again and see what happens. And now we're much closer. We've got about 5 volts to 5.35 volts. Looks like we've overshot our target by a little bit, so let's change it to 800 ohms, run the simulation again, and sometimes you just have to do this in engineering. Just keep doing things over and over again until you get the result that you want. Okay, looks like we've got about 0.45 volts out on the amplifier now, and that's roughly where I want it to be, so let's just leave it at that. And if you're curious, let's poke around at some of the other voltages in the circuit. Over here, we would expect this to be a flat line of 9 volts, and yes it is. The middle of our voltage divider, you know voltage dividers. 10K here, 10K there, we're dividing it evenly by 2, so this should be 4.5 volts. Yes it is, 4.5 volts, and we've got a little 20 millivolt AC swing laid on top of it. And we can just keep looking at all kinds of currents and voltages in the circuit to, you know, see whatever we want to see, analyze whatever we want to analyze, and make adjustments accordingly. Okay, that covers the basics of circuit simulation, so give it a try.